Hey, this is Sean. What is going on? Let's see. Let's put me over here. Get me out of the way here. I thought I'd have the AI tell me about my program. I've been asking the AI all kinds of crap today. Doing the Midjourney, having it look at my code. I'm tempted to have it write my next, I'm doing Girls Gone Vampire. I'm tempted to have the AI write the next cult, the ones that are the werecats, were tigers, as it were, from India. Yeah, I'm curious how the AI would write that. Let's see here. So the AI, so far, I asked the thing, what do you think of my vampire, my vampire. When you click on the vampire checkbox, it then converts the character you made into a vampire. So it says, the selected code is part of a function in a GUI application that is used to create a vampire character. The function is called vampire checkbox changed. I probably should change that to something. I should call it something like, your character is now a vampire. And it is responsible for turning the character into a vampire when the vampire checkbox is checked. Remember, those of you in the know who played around with Bryce or Poser or Fractal Painter, you would read the instructions and it would say, the view box, when selected, selects the view box selected camera view, you know, those kinds of things. By turning the knob on the brightness, you are adjusting the brightness of your colors, you know. The paint mixer mixes your paints. The cancel button cancels your last option, you know. That's how Poser manuals were written back in the 90s and early 2000s. The finger button allows you to move the finger. It's like, great. Well, that's kind of what I think so far about this AI. But, you know, some people want documentation. So, responsible for turning the character into a vampire when the vampire checkbox is checked. I like how it enunciates is checked. So the function starts by checking if the character is currently being created or loaded. Ooh. Okay. Yeah, it is. That's smart. I don't know how it figured that out, but yeah, it's checking to see, is this a false positive? Because I have a lot. Anyway, my software tends to have unreliable narration in it, so the computer has to double check. Is this for real? Are you for real turning me into a vampire, or is this just you just doing something? You're doing something. So I have these things like, okay, don't worry, don't panic. I'm not turning the character into a vampire. I'm just reloading an existing character I made previously that already is a vampire. So you don't change him into a vampire. I mean, this is the girls. These are girls right here. The Boetian Club. These are all females. So it's like, don't change the vampire into a vampire. They're already a vampire. That's what it's doing. And then here it's like, you're clearing out the character to make a new character? Okay, so don't make them a vampire soon after. Like, don't, when you clear out the character sheet, we're just clearing the flag. We're clearing clearing the vampire checkbox, which means don't turn them into a vampire. Not yet. So then what happens? If so, it skips the vampire transformation and returns. That is good. That is good. I like how this AI uses its own words. It's not just plagiarizing what I type. It's actually, I don't use the word vampire transformation. I don't use transformation at all. Or returns. I don't use returns, so that's good. See, the AI has learned over the years, over its 3 months of existence. It's learned. 3 months in AI time is decades. It's learned how vampire transformation code is properly written so that it understands the code that I wrote last week. Because it already knows this stuff, obviously. Obviously, AIs know about character generation and being able to just flip on the vampire switch to make your character a vampire. All AIs know this, well, at least this one does. I'm using Tab 9, the free version. I may end up buying it because the buying version of it is pretty darn good. Let's see. Next, the function sets the vampire flag to true and disables the vampire checkbox. True, true, yeah. So it knows Python. It helps that the AI knows Python. It helps that the AI knows the mod I'm using for Python. It helps that the AI knows that I've configured the mod that I'm using for Python. It just figures this out. The function then checks which cult the character belongs to. All right. It does. Is it this cult? Is the only one I have written so far. So tonight I'm going to start writing the next cult in the book. This book here. I finished reading this one. Can you see it, Enterprise? This is the Girls Gone Vampire Survivor's Guide. It's got some cool 50s artwork in there. You know, little West Side Story, a little Rebel Without a Cause, a little Streetcar Named Desire, a little of this, a little of that. The Bachelor and the Bobby Soxer. That was in the 40s, I think. Anyway, so I read that book today to get some ideas. It's got vampire hunters in that book. This is for vampires. And there's the Knight's Blood. That's a cult of, I want to say they're vampire hunters, kind of in a way, in a sort of way, kind of cool. Anyway, so what are you doing now? What are we doing next? Okay, so if the character belongs to the bow, I don't know how to say this. How do you say this? Oh, I can't highlight it. Oh, there we go. I don't know how to say that word. Hang on. Can I find another AI to read that for me?
Beosha.
Okay, Beoshian then. Beoshian Club? Beoshian. Oh, the first O is silent. Okay. I was saying Boeotian. It's Beoshian. Okay. Hi. So if the character belongs to that club, the function logs a message and it does? Oh, yeah. Turn character into a psychic vampire. Don't read your log. I mean, when you're making your character, maybe you'll be tempted to look at the log file and you'll see this kind of stuff happening. It's your backstory. That'll be the log file is your character's backstory. So, sets the character's attributes and status levels to 5, 2, and 2. 5, 2, and 2. Where did it get that number from? 5, 2, and 2. I don't know where it's getting that from. It also sets the score cap to 5 and the skill cap to 3. It does? Okay, your skill cap is 3, score cap is 5. Where is it getting the first 5, though? Where is it getting 5 from? Interesting. Wonder how it figured that one out. I did play a game I mean, not play. I did make a character that had five body. And then they got turned into a vampire. No, it doesn't make sense. 5-2 and 2. I don't know where it's getting. It's supposed to be. Okay. It knows what the one and the two mean. Well, one is mind, two is spirit, zero is body. It should be whatever the character's original body was, it retains that. They still keep that score, but their mind and their spirit get changed to two and four. But where did it get the 5-2 and two from? The function then sets the body, mind score, and spirit score values to the current attribute scores. Okay. So I'm setting the caps for the body, mind, and spirit, setting their caps. Basically, you can't go above three, can't go above four, that sort of thing. Here it looks like the score cap is at five. I set it, I want to say the book says that. So that's probably why. Maybe that's why it's thinking the five is from this. Four score and seven, it's doing that kind of stuff. Okay. The function then updates the health, sanity, and morale displays with the new attribute scores. Does it? Oh yeah, it does. Health, sanity, morale. Morale, moral, morale. It does. It does. Then what does it do? The function then sets the maximum values for the skills to the new skill cap. How does it know that? How does it know I'm doing that? It is. It does know that. So it's setting the skills to a skill cap of three. So these are what are these things? These are your not your special skills, but your standard skills. So their cap is at three for now. And then some of them, was it the it says divine skills you don't get to have if you're a vampire. So no bless, no exorcism, and no healing for vampire. At least for the psychic vampires. I don't know about the other vampires yet. Have not read. I have not. See, this is the thing. I'm writing a program for a role-playing game that I have not finished reading. I read a page, I program. I read a page, I program. I read a page, I program. So I don't know how this program's going to end up. I don't know how. I don't even know if the program will be runnable when I finish reading the book. And let's see. And then some of these it mentions. I put the caps at four for the psionic skills because you might be. I don't know. These are special. These are the specialty skills, so they can be at four. The rest can be at three. And then it mentioned in the book something about demonology is preferred. Not sure what that means. I mean, I know what it means, but why did it do this? Because this is the same as these, right? Skill cap. Maybe I changed. I might change this to four. I'm not sure yet. Maybe it gets changed later. It probably gets changed later. This is just a reminder for me to notice that the book said that vampires prefer demonology skill over metamorphosis and necromancy. Aren't these cool? Aren't these cool looking spells? Necromancy and metamorphosis? and demonology? I mean, what role-playing game do you know has those kinds of skills in it? And let's see. What does it do next? Next, it does... the function then sets the skill values to 0 and sets the temporary skill values to the current skill values. That's true. It did that up here. I guess it does it down here too. Oh yeah, it does. Temporary. I'll eventually make a function to have it just do this. Instead of just me plagiarizing myself. Yeah, you have temporary values. Because, you know, you might decide, you know what, I don't want to change that value so it remembers what the original value was. In theory. Let's see. Then what happens? The function, okay, I read that one already. Yeah, the function, okay, I keep saying the function. Yes, I use functions, okay? I use functions. I don't use class, I use functions. The function then updates the reward display with the new skill values. Does it? It does. Here's the reward. It updates the reward. So it adds up the points of all your skills, and that's your XP reward for yourself. If someone kills you, that's how much XP they get from your dead husk. What else happens? Let's see. The function then sets the movement, action, and reaction values to 3, 2, 5. 3, 2, 5? Ooh. I like how it thinks it knows what these are. So vampires get... you know, it's kind of close. I'm... This is what happened. I have a confession to make. This is what happened. So these three here. This is encumbrance, movement, and range. Now I'm using the same variable names that I used, I don't know, 2 years ago when I started writing these programs for Total Party Skills. 2 years ago. These are the variables I used. Well, since then, the book has been updated. I guess version, one could say the 2.0 rules for TPS have been released. That's the, it's this book here. This book here. Total Party Skills Handbook. I call this 2.0. There was like 1.5. Version 1.5 was the Space Cadets in the 11th Dimension, you know, that kind of thing. That one had the latest rules. Then the handbook had the latest rules. So since then... these have changed. This is now, what does the AI say it is now? Movement, action, and what is it? Anyway, it means these variables are the same name, but they mean different things now. Just to stay, just so I stay compatible with it. Legacy compatible with 2-year-old software. Anyway, in the comments, I think it's reading the comments sections in my code to get this stuff. Yeah. Anyway, so one is... but heck, let's just run it and see. We'll just run it. Surely it can run. It is the encumbrance... okay, it's combat... travel and flight. So one is encumbrance, travel. You know, it's these things. Right now they're 2, 2, 2. And if you become a vampire, the 2, 2, 2 become 3, 2, 5. In theory. Let's see. The function then sets the encumbered flag to false and disables the encumbered checkbox. Yes, that's true. That's what happened. That's exactly right. The function then sets the vampire care gen flag to true. Where's that at? Ba, 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 ba. Oh, here it is. How does it know that's a flag? AI, this AI is based. Or next is next, this AI is going to be saying slave and master hard drives. Totally politically correct. The function then clears the role, cover, gender, and cult combo boxes. Ooh. And sets the role choices, skill bonuses, and item rewards to for each cult. Oh, it called these things item rewards. That's neat. So yeah, we got the these are combo boxes. You can choose your role, which then chooses what your role affects, your mind, your spirit, your combat, your strange, you know, the skills that it become specialized. And it also gives you items. A nice watch, a flask, a pistol, a briefcase, a sword. Gosh. Your character can have a sword. Now, your cover can have a cheap suit, fashionable clothing, a track suit, plain clothes. And your cover choice can be a dancer, a model, teacher, critic, radio DJ, a lawyer, an author, you know, that kind of thing. Kind of neat. What else we got here? The function then sets the vampire Kerrigan flag to true and disables the role, cover, gender, and cult boxes. Cult combo boxes, yeah. So after you pick your thing, it then turns off those boxes, so you don't get to choose over again. You get one chance to choose, and when you choose, poof. I don't want to write a manual on how to use this app. So the app is sort of, you push this button unlocks. You push this button, something else unlocks. So. And when you can no longer click on anything in the Kerrigan app, your character is now complete. All you can do then at that point is roll. And that's a different app, the die roller. Let's see here. What are we doing here? The function then sets the additional skill points to 2 and sets the additional skills, additional points display to the current value. Does it? It does. It sets it to 2. So you get 2 extra points. In something. Oh yeah, you get 2 extra psionic points, it looks like. Ooh. I'll have to double check that. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, 2 and then extra. Yeah. Okay. I guess these come as a set, it looks like. Then what happens? The function then sets the flag to true to indicate that the extra 2 psionic skills have been chosen. Yeah, kind of. It's setting the flag for, I am choosing 2 points only for psionics, right? Only these 2 points only go into psionics, nowhere else. I know I'm using a flag here for now, but this will get turned into something else, something less readable, more abstract. So this function can get reused thousands of times for various occasions. But for now, it's just this. Like I said, when I read more of the book, this code will change each time I read another chapter of the book. And what do we got here? The function ends by logging a message and returning. Does it? Does it? Where's the log? Where does it log something? I only saw one log in here. I like how it took this boring ass code, just linear procedural, you know, fill in these blanks. Turn on the button so you can click on them, sort of thing. I like how it turned that into something, I don't know, like you know, something remotely interesting. It's got vampire. They're talking about vampires and sanity and health and morale. You know. But then you look at it, it's like, that looks so boring. Coding is so boring. Like, this is the only log I have, is this one. Okay. Anything else? Oh, is there more? No, it's done. It's over. That was neat. I forgot something. It's got a little thing here I can ask. Why not? What is the purpose of the vampire checkbox change function in the context of the GUI application? Let's find out. I like how it types. It's, the AIs type like a slow line printer from like the mid 80s. Oh, he's done? Okay. The purpose of the vampire checkbox change function is to turn the character into a vampire when the vampire checkbox is checked. The function is part of a GUI application that allows users to create a vampire character. So, it doesn't know that this is Total Party Skills yet. I mean, it's going just from here. It's just going, you know, with these 40 lines of code. It doesn't see the broader picture, obviously. In the context of the GUI, I keep wanting to say GUI, the GUI application, some people in the 80s, some people would say GUI. GUI. I say GUI. Some people say GUI. Anyway, the vampire checkbox change function is responsible for performing the following tasks. Okay, so it's going to give me a rehash of what I already said. So, in summary, what is the purpose of the vampire check function? Okay, I thought it would give me another thing. How about, let's go somewhere else. Let's go somewhere interesting. Is there like a really cool part? I don't think there's a cool part. Is there a load? Can we go to load, maybe? Oh, clear? No. Let's go to load. Is there a load? Load? Where's load? I mean, what can it say about body? What will it say about body? Anything? Tell me about the body. Are you of the body? How do I do this? How do I get... I want you to explain this to me. Do I have to highlight something? Here we go. Explain this code. Working. Okay. The selected code is part of a function in... Oh, I thought you were done. The selected code is part of a function in the code you provided. It is used to update the display of the character's attributes and skills based on the changes made to the body, mind, and spirit. Really? I only highlighted the body part. But it knows the other stuff. How? How does it know? How does it know this? Here's body. I guess it knows mine from here. From these two guys here. It knows it's looking at the GUI and it's understanding from the GUI that there's other parts to this puzzle. The code starts by calculating the new values for the character's encumbrance, movement, and range based on the current values of the body, mind, and strength skills, as well as the body score. Yeah, that's true. The body score is used for encumbrance. And then this is the section on body score, because this is what happens when you click on the body button. If you click the body button, it runs this. And it's making references to other parts of your character. It also mentions the save. Oh, here's the action. It mentions the save, the action, and the print functions. Is it going to do that too? Let's see. It then updates the additional attribute points variable to reflect the difference between the current and previous values of the body score. Yeah, so if I've run out of an additional attribute points, it then goes on to the next thing. It says, oh, you're done? You're done? So you get to save your character now, basically? Because you can't save your character until your character is basically finished. You know, you need a character on your character sheet first before you can save your character. I don't have dynamic saving, which means you can just type in your character name and then save. You can just type your character's name, you can just type in their age, their sex, and then save. No. You have to have body, mind, spirit. You have to have some skills. And you have to have you have to sign up for a role, you know, a cult. You have to have some sort of a cover, you know, your fake job that you're doing to hide what you truly are. Those things have to be chosen before you can save your character. I mean, it's not like a video game where, oh my God, I didn't save. You know, it's not like that. And you'll be saving your character pretty soon. I mean, it doesn't take long to pick some skills for your character. Okay, what does it do next? The code then updates the health, sanity, and morale scores. It does? Where does it do that? I know it's looking for if your encumbrance is going to be jacked up or not, based on your health. You know, if you're mortally wounded, if you're injured, it's going to mention that in red. It's going to say that in red. I should probably double check that. It looks like it's if you use up all your attribute points, it'll display in red. But I don't think, yeah, when you're doing your body, you can only increment. You can't de-increment. So don't have to worry about your health being in red. Don't have to worry about your health, your character being damaged while making your character. But how does it know about sanity and morale, though? How does it know? It just does. I guess it's linking the mind and the spirit to the sanity and morale. Very clever. I mean, that's how I wrote this program, but it's clever that the AI did like a thorough reading of the program, and it understands what it's doing as best as it. I mean, does the AI know what health, sanity, and morale is? That would be cool if the AI knew that, but I think it just, I could have said Bob, Dick, and Harry, and it would say Bob, Dick, and Harry, right? Anyway, the code then update. Yeah, so then what if the additional attribute points variable is zero, the code enables the XP edit box. Yeah, that's true. You can now start typing in how much XP your character gains during the game. And it disables the encumbrance, the vampire, and the save buttons, and enables the print and print preview buttons. Does it disable the save buttons? I don't think so. It's setting disabled to false. Maybe it doesn't know what false means for disable. It's a double negative. I'm I'm setting the save button using a double negative. Two wrongs make a right. Let's see. If it also enables the vampire checkbox if the character is at level 3 and not a vampire. Oh, does it now? It does. So if the character is not level 3, what happens? Then it leaves the vampire checkbox box alone, which means disabled. You can't click on the make me a vampire. You can't click on that check mark if you're not level 3 yet. And if you're already level 3 or if you're level 3 and the vampire flag is false, it comes on. But if you're not level 3 or if you're already a vampire, the vampire box does not ever get set. Is that right? I'll have to double check. If you're level 4, it should still be flagged as checkable. I'll have to try that. Or what the AI is talking about is this. There's a vampire checkbox here. And right now, I can't click on it. So if I load somebody, what happens? Are they already a vampire? See, they're already a vampire. If I load on this person, they're already a vampire. So let's make a new person real quick. Female, this one. See, they're 20-something, 23, I guess. They got some skills. Choose, let's see, they're an assassin. So now they've got dodge and strike. Now I got 8 skills I can throw into here, so they're going to know some of this, some of this, some of that, some of this. Why not? Now choose a cover, security. And security added, it looks like it added 1 here for focus. Now I can go in here and say, the thing, the body, the mind. Now I can start doing XP stuff. Get more points, put it into strength. More XP, put it into strength. And agility, more XP. So now I'm level 2 and it's not checked off yet, so I can't. One more maybe. And I can increase mind. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm at level 3 and it's checked this thing off. I mean, it's enabled. I can, if I click this, I'm now a vampire. I'm going to see if I can go. Should I be a vampire? No, I want to continue before I become a vampire. So now I'm at level 4. I get 3 points, so I can go agility, strength, and melee. So I'm just checking. So I'm, what does it say now? So, yeah, there's no else. There's no else here. So once this vampire checkbox set disabled false happens, it stays that way. So I wanted to check that if I become level 4, it turns this off. So I don't have another chance to become a vampire. So as long as it's, when it was 3, it got turned, the disabled flag got turned off. If I hit this, boom, I'm now a vampire. And I'm reset to level 0. And I gotta fix this. This needs to be set to disable. I'm not supposed to pick anything here yet. I gotta fix that. See, every time I record these things, I find a bug. So why did this get uncovered? So I get two skills to go and do this thing. And yeah, so this is messed up. Yay, I found a bug. Again. Let's fix that now, shall we?